one. Right. I think I've got it working now. Oh, I'm glad I wasn't streaming. I've just tried to work out how to do this by myself, and I had everything right, and I just did the video. Everything was fine, apart from no one could hear me, apart from me. Honestly, the joys of technology. Hello. Basically, we have been given a leak. Fantastic. Good news about Hogwarts Legacy. We have been given a leak about the North Tower. Now, what do we know about the North Tower before we start this? First of all, we know that the North Tower is on the 7th floor. We know that what gets taught on the 7th floor, which is the divination, as well as arithmancy. So, we know those things. From what I can tell from the start off though, we have a centaur. Now, we know that the centaurs can read the future. We get to know that from the 5th book, which is Order of the Phoenix, and we also get to know it from the 1st book as well, in the Philosopher's Stone. They take much stark from the planets and they like to read them. You'll know if you have read the 1st book recently, like I have. Mars shines brightly. And it's all they can talk about when they're in a forbidden forest. Planet gazes and all the rest of it. So, for have a centaur on the 7th floor, where they teach divination, honestly, truthfully, not a big leap, not a necessarily a leap where I'm like, ooh, could a centaur be a teacher? Most likely, I mean, a centaur has taught before. So maybe this is saying that a centaur is teaching, or maybe it's showing those who can read the future who are other than humans in great stature. Maybe that is why there are centaurs on this floor. Who knows? But let's play the game. Now, this video is really, really short. It is literally 21 seconds. It is tiny of a video. So, it doesn't show us off a lot. So, unless you know book lore, as well as game lore, such as on the 7th floor we have divination classrooms in, I guess, the 1st, the 2nd, but not in the 3rd game. You know, you wouldn't really know this is divination. I think in Order of the Phoenix and in Half-Blood Prince though, when you explore the floor of the 7th floor, it is very empty. It is very empty and it's very generic, and also you kind of know Trelawney's on that floor via up the staircase, but like, it's very empty. And we then get to find out that the 7th floor is connected to the 6th floor as well. So whether they follow the same design, I don't think they will, because like I say in previous videos when I've watched Hogwarts Legacy, it looks like they're going from a castle from scratch. So I don't think they would connect. And if it is a centaur teaching the class, does that mean that this is entrance within the ground floor, and it's technically the 7th floor that it gets taught on, but technically not how it plays within a castle? Is that what this is telling us? Who knows? All we get is just the North Tower. So could it be the entrance to the North Tower that we see this in? Lots of tapestries about centaurs here. Again, is it just holding them in a higher stature? Oh, what was that? Hang on. I've seen something I like. Go back. Go back, Mr. Video. Go back. There. That's it. The green light. What are you about? Could you be to do a divination? Could be divination magic? Could it be arithmancy magic? Who knows? Okay, I just had an idea. What about if it is, and this is a long shot, but might not be the actually that long shot actually. If you do well in divination and you decide to take it up as a thing, if you go up to any green flames like that and you put your hand or whatever in, does it make you have visions? Or does it do maybe, would you press R3 and maybe do this a very similar thing like they do in Assassin's Creed? If you press R3 in Assassin's Creed Valhalla, it shows up a blue, it does a little blue flash, and it shows you where gold is, and it shows you where things to help you out on quests are, and also shows you like where guards are and stuff like that. Could it be something like that? Similarly? Don't know. I mean, it's not a long stretch, it could be. And then those are statues of centaurs. Again. Could it be that we have a centaur teaching us divination? And that's just the entrance to the North Tower, and the North Tower is on the ground floor, instead of up a flight of stairs like it has been previously in previous games. Could it be like that? Because previously, in how to get there in the other games, so in 1st, 2nd and 3rd, and also 5th and 6th, you go up the great staircase, moving staircases, you go up there, and you get up to the top, and then when you get up to the top, you can get to the 7th floor, and that's about it. But in the 6th game, you were able to get to Slughorn's party via going, I think it was like, you went down into the dungeons, and you went back up. Could it be the case that it's very similar in that sense of, because the 6th floor and the 7th floor were connected together in the 5th and 6th games. And like I say, that new bit where you went from the dungeons and you went all the way back up, remembering it very much from when you would guide Luna to Slughorn's party, and I believe Slughorn's party was on the 7th floor. Because that's where his office is. Which, by the way, we probably will have an office there, but we will not have Slughorn in there because Slughorn has not come to teach yet. So, yeah, it might be somebody else's office. But anyways, that's beside the point. Could it possibly be that that is the entrance to the North Tower? Therefore, is classed the North Tower. Therefore, is on the ground floor. Could it possibly be that we have a centaur teaching us divination? Or is it that centaurs are literally just hide in good esteem, they're popped a lot on that floor because they can read the future? That's it. But it seems very unusual to have like loads of them all together. I don't know. Definitely more to think about that. But there is a possibility. Because like I say, in the 6th game, you can get there two ways. You can travel either by the great staircase, which is with the moving stairs, up to the 7th floor. Or you can either go there from via the dungeons back up. So, is it the case that maybe in the past, that wasn't in the dungeons, and it's through just decay or matter or something like that it's then proceeded into the dungeon. Who knows? I don't know. But that's my guess from the looks of things. But to be fair, there wasn't, in any of the games, there wasn't an awful lot on the 7th floor. I mean, like I say, in Ordered and Phoenix, it was very empty and very generic, and it was almost like it was a complete copy of the floor below it, which is the 6th floor, which they put the room requirement on. And the same again when it came to the 6th game. Again, it was very generic. It was very much the same floor below it. And then the floor below it is where, again, the room requirement was. So, who's to say? I'm glad of adding a little bit more to it, actually. It makes it more interesting. Because I always remembered when you play Order and Phoenix, the 7th floor is very hilarious. Because I think at the beginning of the floor, there's a little knight in little armour. And at the end of the floor, there was a knight who was rather large. And that's how I remembered that floor. And like I say, it's the only time, I think, in the 5th and 6th game where they're kind of apart from the common room. In the 1st and 2nd and 3rd, technically 3rd game, because we have the North Wing, they're kind of like together still. So, but maybe this is the start of the tower, so being at the very top of the tower, like it is in Trelawney's Day, maybe it's at the start, at the base of the tower, where divination gets taught. Which is technically still the 7th floor, it's just further down the tower. Maybe. Who knows? Nonetheless, it's very interesting to find this link, and I hope there is a few more, but we still haven't been given a date for it yet. Hopefully we get one soon. So yes. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. See you later. Bye.